I got many comments lately that they comments about self-reliance in a way that is different from the meaning that we understand it. It seems like people understand the meaning of self-reliance in different way. Some people believe that self-reliance is mean we isolate ourselves, we love to have a hard life, have to be alone, do everything by ourselves, don't connect with other people, or refuse money, refuse technology, refuse progressive way of life. So there are many people have different meaning, different understanding about self-reliance. And I think it's hard to communicate together. But for us, self-reliance for us means how can we rely on ourselves, at least in the four basic needs: food, shelter, daily needs, and healing. This the basic thing that we need to be able to rely on ourselves as much as we can. So it's like a roots of our life. If we have good roots, we will be strong and stable in the wind, in the storm. We don't worry. And after that, we can do anything. We can do whatever we want. So it's very open. But we just want to have a good root. That's the main idea. And another way is when we talk about self-reliance, it means we try to not rely on in the big system too much. Try to rely on the big system as less as we can. But we rely on ourselves more. And rely on ourselves means rely on each other too. So it means if we don't like something, don't do it. Do what we like. And what we don't like, but we need to use it, we just rely on other people. For example, I don't like to make soy sauce. I don't like to grow soybean. I just rely on other people who love to grow soybean, who love to make soy sauce. So we just help each other like this. It will create a microeconomics. And then we rely on each other and help each other. So everybody can survive together. It's impossible to be alone. It's impossible for one person to do everything by themselves. It's too much work. It's not very fun. And it's very lonely. So self-reliance is mean rely on ourselves and rely on each other. So it's not about isolate ourselves at all. And then we did not refuse money. We did not refuse technology. We use everything. But the main thing is we use it with consciousness or mindfulness. Mindfulness is mean we use reason to make decision. If we want something, we want to buy something, we need to think, is it necessary for us or not? Or it just, we like it. If it's necessary, we just buy it, use it. But if only we like it, we don't buy it. So when we use mindfulness lead our life. Use mindfulness help us to lead our decision in daily life. We will spend less and less and less money. Even we have less income, but we will have less worry, less debt in our life. Mindfulness will help us to understand what we need or what we want. So whenever we buy what we need, it's always important. We have to buy it. We have to use it. But what we want is not important. We just like it or want it. So if we let mindfulness help us to make decision like this often, it will be our new character, new habit, that we buy everything, we will think it first, need or want. If it's need, buy it. If it's want, don't buy it. So this is the way we live in the self-reliant way. So when we live in this way, we will have less and less and less burden in our life. When we have less burden, less material, less thing to carry, our life will be very light. When it's light, that means it's freedom. We have less worry, less fear. We can do anything we want. So to be self-reliant, it doesn't mean we need to be poor. It doesn't mean we have to be in the hard time, have a hard life. It doesn't mean we refuse everything. No, it's not like that. If it's hard, I don't want it. I don't like hard life. I like to make it easy, make it fun. So self-reliant helped me to have easy life and have a lot of fun. That's why I choose to live like this. So when we become self-reliant, we have a lot of confidence inside us. Because we don't need to depend on other people so much, we know that we can build our own shelter anywhere, anytime, with everything around us. Even we have less money, we can build a good house to stay. And then we know that what is edible, and then we know how to grow food, how to find the food that we want anywhere. So even we have less money, we not worry about food at all. We can find something to eat anytime, anywhere. And then whatever we use in our daily life, we know how to do it. We know how to make shampoo. We know how to make soap. We know how to make toothpaste. We know how to make sauce. We know how to fix things. We know how to do many things in our life. That helps us to feel very relaxed. If not, we're going to be very worried when the pump doesn't work. Oh, it's a headache. We have no water to use. When the light bulb's broken, oh, it's a headache. We need to looking for special people to come and fix it. But when we know how to do things, it's so simple. We just change the light bulbs easily. We fix things easily. This is freedom. And then when we know how to do the basic healing for ourselves, we have less fear, less worry about sickness. But it doesn't mean we refuse conventional healing. We did not refuse conventional medicine. We will help ourselves with the local wisdom first, with our technique first. If we cannot help ourselves, we can go to conventional healing, conventional medicine. We did not refuse it, but we keep it as the last choice. That's all. So when we live like this, it makes things very easy. Very easy. When people comment that, oh, you talk about self-reliance, but why you fly? Why you use internet? That means they don't understand the meaning of self-reliance in the same way that we understand. Self-reliance is mean we did not refuse anything. We use everything, but we use with mindfulness, with the awareness that we use because of it's important. So when we live like this, we have enough food to eat. We have good place to stay. We have good shade, good tree. We have good weather. We have everything we need. And when we have more than we need, we can save it for emergency time or for crisis time. Like now, today, we have the tuber planting gathering here because we think tuber is the most important thing. It's very secure when we have it under the ground. So we just invite people all over. We have more than 60 people come here today to plant tubers here. And everybody come from different places because they have time. They have free time. They have enough for themselves. They can rely on themselves. And now they just share the spare time, share their labor, come help to grow tubers in this piece of land. It's quite a big piece of land. We want to save this tuber for emergency time or for the next generation. That's why we just come and help. Nobody pay anybody to come, but we come because we have fun. We can be together, we joke around, we fun, we eat together. It's a community. So if we have like this once a month or 2 months, 3 months, we have some event like this one time, that's the way we can enjoy our life. So for people who like to comment that, if you are self-reliant, why you have to fly? Why you can have internet? Why you can go that place, this place? I want to make it clear that we understand self-reliant in different way. When people understand that self-reliance means you need to do everything yourself and then disconnect yourself from everything, we don't like that idea. I don't think it's fun to live like that. We don't want to isolate ourselves from anything. We want to have a community. We want to be together. We want to share. We want to help. So we work less. So we don't need to do everything ourselves. We do what we like to do. What we don't like to do, we just rely on other people nearby us. But the main thing, we try to rely on the big system as less as we can. This is the meaning of self-reliance for us. That's why we have time to do whatever we want to do. We can go wherever we want to go. It's fun. It's real life. Every minute for us is so precious time. We enjoy it every minute. So self-reliance is freedom. Self-reliance is happiness. Self-reliance is security.